I was sent abroad, precisely to New York, to the United Nations, with the trust of the people to speak for them. That trust that people bestowed on me, my colleagues who stayed behind, was sacred. A whole nation is occupied, invaded. I knew crimes were being committed. So I would be a lesser human being. I could not look at myself in the mirror, knowing that I had abandoned them. In the early stages, very, very few activists were around in support. Really, they were like a dwindling species. And I networked, built that network slowly around the world. Internet made the world smaller, easier for groups to connect with each other, easier for me to communicate. I would travel everywhere in this country. I would go to places like New Orleans, to Chicago, to Birmingham, everywhere. And there are a few people in a room to listen to me. 6 people, 10 people, 20. Then came the Nobel Peace Prize in 1996. Of course, that was a big turning point. Then the audiences increased by the hundreds, by the thousands, depend where I went. And that meant increasing pressure on Indonesia. The international solidarity movement was instrumental. They were like our peaceful foot soldiers that fought many battles for us through the internet, letter writing to the US Congress or European Parliament, governments. They would use, of course, peaceful demonstrations. That's around the world, including in the United States. There are impossible dreams that can be realized when you stay focused, when you are persistent, you're stubborn, but also, of course, be rational, be flexible. In the pursuit of justice, being stubborn, being determined doesn't mean being irrational, being dogmatic, or being demagogic, or being fanatic.